So hi friends, today I'll be showing you how to remove the background from images which I have chosen randomly from Google. So I'll show you a various techniques where you can exactly do a removal, and based on each and everything there is a different style and different way of utilizing our selection tools. So first thing, I'll start with a giraffe with a background of white. So let us see how we can do this. So basically how we can do this is simply we can choose a quick selection. Okay, once you have a quick selection tool over here, you can just click on it and press, as the giraffe image is already totally white, so you won't be having much difficulties over here. But when you see that there are some of the images where you can, so I'm using a open brace, okay, to reduce my brush over here. Now I'm pressing Alt, so that I'll be negativing the wanted part which I require for the image. So just I'm selecting this particular part right now. So even the middle white is also getting selected. No problem, we can work on them. So first let me try to get these legs into the image. Okay. Yeah. Now I'll still reduce it by open bracket. And now selecting this particular area. So okay, now I'm doing the same thing over here also. So there are some selection points over here where it is white. Okay, so overall you can see the giraffe is totally selected. Now for the best part of the removal, I don't erase them actually, so I use a masking tool over here. So click on this masking tool, but what you get is an inverted image over here. But what you can do is Control I, you can use on the Windows. So once you do that, automatically what happens, you got a new and neat image where you don't have it in the background. So let us go with the next part of removing the background from this image. Here you can see it's not everything the same color of white which we have seen before. So how do you do that? What I'm going to do is I'm going to take magnetic lasso tool. Okay, I'm selecting from this particular point. I'm just hovering over here. I'm not trying to click anywhere. I'm trying to just take the mouse pointer on top of it. So I'm just zooming in so that I have better clarity. So if you miss any of the points, you can click backspace and again you can come start over. Okay, right now this is fine. I can, so some points you may need to use backspace to remove those points and come back. Okay, here you can see that this particular image where it is not getting selected. So here manually I am clicking so that I can do the selection process, because system is unable to exactly verify which one is the wanted and unwanted part. So wherever it shows a difficulty as such, I'll take a call over there. So again backspace. Sorry, I'm a little messy. It is dark black and it is unable to even detect. So let me do it a quick thing. Once I'm back with that, I'm taking a rough selection for now. I don't want to waste your time. So you get my point, right? So if you want, you can get that part of unwanted selection back. So we will be facing these kind of difficulties where there are both dark colors or light colors. Otherwise, you will be able to select the part very easily. Okay, almost done. I'm pressing spacebar in between of moving. Okay. Selection. You may feel this is a tedious thing, but once this is done, you will see an excellent result. So the same way which we have done previously, we use the masking. So as I told, I'll show you a different technique to get back the part. Don't worry. So here is this. I'm selecting a brush tool. Right now I'm selecting the mask area only. So I'm doing it manually, but you get my point, right? So yes, you did not erase or delete on the parts which you don't require. You can get them back while you're doing the part. Okay, so this is, I feel, much more better than the previous. This is sufficient for me, my purpose actually. Okay, so we have seen two. One is giraffe, we have removed the background of only white. Here we have removed gray shaded background. Now we are going to go for the next one. So here you can see there are mountains. So basically, I just want to, if you want specifically to remove the part of the sky, okay, you can do the same way which we have done previously. I'm trying to use a different tool for each and every image, so you get the basic point. So here I'm taking the magic tool. Here I'm pressing shift to have multiple points. You get me, right? So basically, major part which I require, I'm trying to get those. So all the tools which you are using are selection right now, so you may see small pieces here and there, but you get the point. So basic gesture I was able to get. So some of the quick points which I don't want, I can come back over here, I can remove them. You can see, all right. So which are close, very close and needy. Okay, so basically majority is covered. Now I'm going to click on the mask. As you know, we will be getting inverted. Click on Control I. You have removed the sky over here. So next image, I think, so you will feel still interesting. So next thing I'm going to take is a tree. It has minute details like leaves, smaller parts. So here also I'm trying to go ahead and remove the background image. Okay, so basically I want to remove the sky out of it. So first thing here, the method we are going to use is through channels. Click on the channels. So basically how we are going to do it is we are going to see which one is having the highest contrast. So which one is darker, which one means. So I'm trying to see which one is the darker. So I feel green is little bit lighter when you compare with the remaining. So blue is a little bit darker. So I'm going to duplicate this particular layer. Okay, I'm going to duplicate the blue channel for now. So I'm going to activate it. I'm going to deselect the previous one. After this, I'm going to shift Control L for the level. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the darker part a little darker and white as still whiter. Okay, so that it will make the Photoshop to recognize and clear it out. So now I'm here. So as I'm selecting on this, now I'll click on Control. Now selection tool is selected. Now I'm going to click on blue copy mask. So it has selected all the spaces. So right now I'll go back to the layer. Okay, I'll click on the image. Still my selection is there. A small ants are going on here and there. So majority part is covered. Let me show you. Now click on the mask. So you can see again the invert image. To get that back, Control I. So you have got the Control I. So you have a clean cut of the tree. There are here and there shades. There are few mountains missing over here. So those things we can get it literally soon. So I'll show you once again. Take the brush. Increase the mesh price by closing. Okay, I know you may feel it as tedious, but the finish definitely it makes worth your time while. Okay, so sorry, I'm little clumsy over here now. Okay, Control Z, X. Here I want to get the details back, so not erase them. So here also. I'm taking advantage of the mask tool pretty much. Okay, so still we can do various activities out here. You can add a background, you can add some detailing. So just for the sake of the argument, I just had a sample of background image, a small display of image where you can see a product display kind of thing. So just I want to take this and take this into background and show you how this will be, can be shown and taken as a background image. Okay, so you can see literally I have added a background over here. Let's do the same. Let's bring the scene over here. Do the same. Control T. Still, the next car image. I'm trying to bring background over here, same way, this smooth area. See, so it's little bit of hanging, No problem. You can click on the car, reduce little bit of the size, little tiny, so that it's staying on the ground, not flying. Okay, just like that. So next one, let's bring the giraffe with the background. Just not bothering about what is the size, what is going on. Yeah, I think so. Hope you guys understood how you can remove the background using different tools which are existing out here, and hope you subscribe the channel. Thank you.